Takalari. Askargabil urrus, ojas tanahi, ojas tanahi, kamin takaladi,
urrutakahi, koduma, ojas urrus. Hello and welcome to the Late Stuff That You Line on Broken, yet another attempt at Nightmare Shadow and Flame. I'm going to be playing a bit faster this time, because I just kind of want to get through this. If you watch the video with my first two attempts, the first two recorded attempts, then you'll see I was taking more time explaining things, but here I want to see if I can power through, especially since I've figured out that I definitely could have actually won at the end of the last attempt had I done something just a little bit differently. So, the second applies me to reveal another card, second deep, it's a bit annoying. This opening hand is fantastic. I have Resourceful, which is the main thing I'm looking for, but I also have Gondorian Shield, which is a fantastic thing to start with. This has Silver Lamp. The Warden of Healing early on may not hurt. I expect Courage also. Okay, so of course, play the shield right away, and then Resourceful goes on Barbon. Resourceful paid for by Barabond. Over here, unexpected Courage right around Barabond, I think. I'll think about that. I will play the ability Lookout immediately. And we see Messing the Deep is coming up. I do not have a test of will. But, okay. Oh, no. So, this is just a thing. If Massing in the Deep comes up in either setup or round one staging in this quest, I'll just scoop the encounter deck. Because, first should be zero, this being the point, Massing in the Deep messes with the design of the quest, because it seems clearly intentional that Durin's Bane is only considered to be engaged with players with a threat of 1 or higher, and you get to start at 0, which means you get a free round. Massing in the Deep takes away your free round, which, like I said, I feel that is against the design of the quest, and also just not fun. So I will cheerfully scoop the encounter deck if that happens. So, okay, this is going to be my first card. It's not going to do anything, but it's going to search. So there's 7 threat in the staging area. That's 2, 5, 9, 11, 13, 14. Now let's hold back some combat power. 11. So this surges into 17. And Goblin Swordsman. Okay. Goblin Swordsman I can deal with. Flame, I can't really. I break even, I don't travel, I engage the Goblin Swordsman. Baragon defends it. And Faramir and Hula can kill it. Good start. Okay. Travel in. So, I definitely want to play the Silver Lamp. Although, of course, actually, Out of Sight and Faint, I could get away with not. But I think it'll be okay. We're going to get set up like this. Right off the bat, This is free. Let's actually let's get allies out first. Memorial doomed to bring out the Warden of Healing. And okay. Some 10 threat in the staging area. That's 2, 5, 6, 10. I should probably try to deal with the Servant of Flame, so I may just still leave it at 10. No, let's put it in. I can do 11. So 11. Goblin Swordsman and Watchful Eyes. I do not have Tested Will, so this is going to be attached to Faramir or Frodo. Frodo. So I've added one threat and I break even. Now, second deep. Do I want to put damage at one endurance bay and explore second deep, or do I want to kill the Servant of Flame? Can I kill the Servant of Flame? It's a pertinent question. 4, 6, 8. No damage on endurance bane, so it's tougher. I think it's probably better to go to the second deep and not engage with these enemies. Still. So, okay, so those are my two shadow effects. And I am going to faint to avoid the first one, Baragon to him, so if we defend the second, then we can attack for 5, 7, 9. And after the regeneration, there's 3 damage left. Okay, control M. Extra healing resourceful is good to see. Another Ringer Scout. It's the 3. Not sure where I want this Doomline Warning, so I think I'll just keep it in hand for the moment. Leave resource for to Eowyn. I have the resources for out of sight. This seems reasonable. 8 threat in the staging area. 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7, 11. And reveal. We can flame. In a second, this it's cancelling it. This attack destroys a character, not a problem. Baragond will take a hit. And second hole. Okay. So as it stands, I'm making no progress. Because I guess I should travel the next. So yeah, let's lose the quest by 1. And I think I can deal with the Servant of Flame. I might be wrong. Bring down here. And then deal out our shadow cards. Okay, so access point this type of character. Okay. So out of sight. Baragon defend the Balrog for this deck. And 4, 6, 8 kills the Servant of Flame. It's got those shadow cards. The Balrog is fully healed by its regeneration. But this is okay. Let's play that out of wild. Five cards. Counterspell can go to the victory display. Well, Maximum Deep was tempting. So yeah, it's okay because I have the West Road Traveler and can just switch these active locations around. Now here. We're going to play King of the Mountain. And okay, discard. Play Tiny Aid. Okay, I guess I'll take the attack power over everything else. Since Baragon already has unexpected courage, defense isn't so needed. The main advantage of the bill is that he's free. So it seems counterintuitive to bring him in with Tiny Aid. So, 4, 5, 8 threat in the staging area. So 2, 5, 6, 7, 11, 13. And we reveal another second deep. And Watchful Eyes. They are limit one per hero, so I'll have to put this one on Faramir. This is a problem. But okay, I've added 3 threats to the staging area. I make 2 progress exploring the second hall. And let's travel to the second deep. Oh, actually, can I get damage on Durantwine? Not without using Faramir, so I'll have to just leave those in the staging area. I will engage the Goblin Swordsman. What would that do? I'm going to try and engage it here, and ready Sam. So, did I forget to reshuffle the Balrog deck? I probably did, but never mind. Okay, so we've got this one. And then the 3 additional shadow cards. Okay, so. Ah, right, yes, this is the perfect thing. Faramir will defend, so I discard all cards attached to him and deal him 1 damage, which I can heal with my Wand of Healing, and then he takes 4 damage from the attack. Got this also with the shadow card. And so then Baragon will defend this one, so this. Nothing. And it's got an ally controls available. Goodbye, Herald Memorian. And nothing. There I go. I think we also defend this. That's my 3 first player issue. Oh, the Goblin Swordsman. And not have enough to do damage. Well, I do have enough to do damage to Durin Kabane, but not enough damage to matter with the regeneration. That's a tricky decision, but I'm going to hold on to timely aid. And, okay, I guess I'm going Gandalf for this round. Shuffle. No. There's not that much damage. Actually, no, there is value in doing damage to Durin's Bane since I've got 2 second deeps in play. So let's do that. Play, and I've got Pylabia, I've already lost to Barragon just next round, I can afford Landreval. Let's play this Damage Runes. Greeting. Okay, so now I'm kind of wishing that I dropped threat with Gandalf because I could drop the step back down to zero, but never mind. I am going to discard the resourceful and play Glaive and draw another card, which turns out to be Arwen. So I'll play Arwen, who, unless I say otherwise. Let's say she'll target the Dundon Wanderer, actually. It's 10 threats in the staging area. 2, 5, 6, 7, 11, 13, 15. Yeah, let's go 15. Your crumbling stairs and save to flame. So that's an extra 5 threat. I'm breaking even. Okay, I break even. I'll travel for the second deep. Now, can I deal with the 7 to flame? Don't need to get some more damage on Durin's Bane if possible, but 7 attack. BB back down to 3. Yeah, I can do that. So 7 to flame comes down here. Sorry, I need to reshuffle the Balrog deck. So that's a destructive character. This is discarding. Oh man. If I had a spare silver lamp. But I don't. So. Barragon will defend this, and he's fine. He will also defend this, and he's fine. And people on the lookout will be killed by this. One with healing heals, one for barrier. So we attack for 7 to kill the 7 to flame, and then I still have 1, 3, 5. So we get a couple more damage on Durin's Bane. I want to use 3. Gandalf to discard at the end of the round. Each shadow card to discard at the end of the combat phase. Control N. Okay, have I discarded any attachments yet? And it didn't have warning, I think. Yeah, not too big a deal. That's true, we came up to 19. Okay, I still don't think it's that big a deal. Glare mine. Deep knowledge. Okay, let's play deep knowledge. And that's what I would take it and resist for most folks. I don't think I did that. No, I did not. So, right. Yes, that's fair. We're going to change for this deck. Okay. Got Sneak Attack Gandalf ready to go. That's good. Let's play the Stargazer. She's mainly intended for the very end of the game. So I can stack the cards to kill Durin's Bane with, but still useful. Ready to land a ball. Play Harold and Morion. Doomed 2, bringing the Defender of Ramos. Okay, and so, okay, I don't want to jinx this, but I'm going to potentially jinx it by saying this is kind of how the, much more how the decks are supposed to play. Things seem to be kind of working for me this time. So, 9 threat in the staging area, request for 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 14, 16. Alright, I'm just going to double. Now I can draw the noble. Okay. That is the one who just did to the Stargazer. And then messing on deep, deep one. Two more cards. Rock Drummer and Counterspell, which I do not have a test of will. So, okay, you turn it against plus X, so this is a 3 and it was right to 2 to this. So I've added 5 threats to the staging area and I make 1 progress. This is frustrating. So under the circumstances, let's discard Greeting and the Dindine Warning to boost Aeowyn so that I can explore the second. Deep. And let's try for Kringle Stairs. What do I do? Just go straight for the other side of deep and simply avoid using events for the time being. Since Counterspell is also in play. So I have to take the Orc Dragon out of the staging area. Let's go here. Reshuffle the Balrog deck. Okay, excess damage and it destroys a character. Neither of those is a problem. Baragon can defend both of them. Finger of Ramos to defend this. Okay. I can heal another bunch of damage from Faramir. He is. Oh no, I see. course he's at 3, but don't think that would lose the 7-9. So let's have 4 attack to kill the Okrona like that, and 3, 5, 7. It's 4 damage, of which 3 will be regenerated. And control it. Okay. Bill's nice, but I don't think that we have a shortage of resources. And this guy is going to help me out with my combat requirements, which are significant, potentially. Okay. So this deck also wants to draw a card with Glare Line. Did not. That's bad. Hang on, no. One thing Deep Knowledge would currently cost a resource for another counter spell. So, at the start of the quest phase, I'm going to play Sneak Attack, which currently costs 2 resources because of the problem downstairs. So, I'm going to Sneak Attack Gandalf. Let's see if I'm counterspelled. I am not counterspelled. Okay. Let's draw 3 cards with Gandalf. Okay. And now, there's 6 threat in the staging area. That's 4, 7, 10, 11, 15, 17, 19. Then we have a chance encounter. So, what is the top end of the discard pile? York Drummer, I'm okay with that. Ready Set, which increases my willpower. And Chance Encounter again, so this will be increasing my willpower again. If there is anything, if there is. But actually, I'm past an engagement cost, so. Sam is not boosted the second time. Oh, right, I've added another threat to the staging area. I make 14 progress. 1, 2, 3. And 11 in here. The Fire Demon is Durin's bane, Doom of the Dwarves, and the new Lord of Moria. It cannot be destroyed by mere strength of arms. We must find another way to deal with this Balrog as it relentlessly attacks, sword and whip weaving a deadly pattern of flame. So, almost there, travel to the crumbling stairs. Gandalf is back in my hand. Reshuffle the Balrog deck. And okay. So, well, Baragon will defend the first one. Each shadow card's an adult face up still. Attacking the different, it's plus 3. I'm okay with that, so. Goblin Swordsman turns up, Baragon takes 3 damage, I have a Warden of Healing. Oh, there's the Shadow cards in here. Oh yeah, technically those Shadow cards should have been, 2 of them should have been here, but I don't know the sequence of the encounter decks, so it shouldn't matter. Baragon can defend this, that's fine. Defender of Rammus can defend this, that's fine. No. Okay. I'm going to go for Out of the Wild first. So, it is counterspelled. There goes counterspell, there goes my command. So, the Doom Dime Wanderer will sentinel defend this. And he's killed. So, Faramir's four attack with new Goblin Swordsman in the staging area, so he can kill the Orc Drummer by himself. Seems like a good idea. And 7 is out of frame. 257 will remain with not enough to damage Durin's Bane. But this is all looking pretty good. Control M. Yeah, sneak attack. It's nice, and the glaring, not so useful. Deep knowledge. I almost discarded my hand, but see what's useful. Okay, range of spikes definitely good. So let's play those Ranger Spikes into the staging area. We'll go to that. Extra resources. Actually, okay, I'll keep the sneak attack to scarf Gandalf. As long as I don't get counterspell, it's better to have more sneak attacks than more Gandalfs. Timely aid. Let's fill out Outrider. Then the power gear and the resource to Faramir. Still could play that Dead-Eye Warning. I actually need to put it onto their end. Okay. And Jones being regenerated, of course. So I have two sneak attacks, that seems like one of them. In the quest phase here, just draw more cards. I'm going through my deck pretty quickly. Damage Durin's Bane, kill the Goblin Swordsman. Killing the Goblin Swordsman is not that difficult. Damage Durin's Bane. I could just try my threat, but I'm not really concerned about it. Starting damage still seems like a reasonable idea. So, 4 damage on Dawnclaw. Questing 4, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 17, 19, 21. I might just blast straight through this, which will be interesting, certainly. Yeah, I should be okay. Reveal. I might have to retract what I said about being okay. Fiery Sword is a problem. Plus 3 attack for the rest of the game. is a big problem. That's something I really want to test a ball for. No such luck. And the wrong enemy lands on the Ranger Spikes once again. But okay, that's two threat added. I'm making 13 progress. 7 goes up here. 6 goes up here. Then I get the 4 at the end of the phase. I certainly could advance right now. I'm definitely considering it. I want to hold on to my sneak attack and my feint, but I can discard a Westfall Outrider to engage this Goblin Swordsman, which is going to engage me anyway. It's ready. No, it doesn't ready Sam because the engagement cost is reduced. But that's fine because I can also discard Glaiwine to boost Eowyn. So I've reduced the threat in the staging area by 1 and increased my willpower by 1. So I make 2 more progress. Quest phase. 4 progress because I committed to Heroes of the Quest and I advance. There is a crumbling pile of boulders on the end of a teetering cliff that gives you a sudden idea. There are chasms and pits along the path we're travelling, and perhaps a well-timed rock slide could send the Balrog down to the depths below. Doom's Bane makes immediate attack on the first player, dark pit to the staging area. So, this deck is the first player. Okay, that is fine. Baragond can... Well, no, wait. It has 9 attack now. So, I mean, Baragon does have 7 defense. It's worth bearing in mind. So, yeah, Baragond could survive. So, yeah, I'm actually going to do that. Baragond will defend, I will heal Faramir, and Baragond will take 2 damage. And heal 2 damage from Durin's Bane. Gandalf returns to my hand. Now, how much damage can I do to Durin's Bane? I could do another 4. Gandalf coming in with an attack. 4, 7, 9, 11, 12. Yeah, not enough. I can take an extra round, though, it's no big deal. I'll bring the 9 attack thing, but I'll manage. Okay, so I don't travel to the Dark Pit, that's the crucial point there. And at the beginning of the quest, not quest, but at the beginning of the. I accidentally discarded this to the one discard pile. It's easy to keep track of because. I know that there are exactly 10 cards in the Balrog deck, so it's easy to just check the numbers. Okay, this shows character and which excess point of combat damage. So one of these is being fainted. Baragond is defending against this. That's fine. But actually, I still want to. And I also sneak attack Gandalf again. Number 4. So. So, who does it want to combat damage? If I defend Gandalf, there will be only one access point of combat damage. So, yep, 9 attack, 4 defense, 4 hit points, so 1 access point of combat damage, which I put in there. Gandalf is dead. And now we can attack back. 4, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9, 13. So 10 damage. Unless I want to take 3 of that away to kill the swordsman. Actually, no, I can deal with the swordsman. I should be able to. So, okay, so this is what Durnsben has after regenerating the round. Then control N. Another feint, that is Fantastic Sea, another Glen, that is not. Everyone's rooms, sure. Resourceful Steward. Steward is better. Players Devil's Rooms. Test of Will. Discard Player Line. Don't actually need a ton of resources. I'm going to place Steward onto Faramir. So that I can do more healing. And I may not bother playing either of these Erebor Hammersmiths for that reason. Resourceful, Anti-Quest Attachment, and save here. So I've got Feint ready to go. Yeah, this seems okay. There's 6 threat in the staging area. I really don't need to quest that hard. 4, 6. I haven't been saying who Arwen's targeting. I guess Arwen will target Beregond so that we actually can defend Balrog without too much concern. What was it? 4, 6, 8, 11, 13, sure. 13 should be fine. I will remove Balin from the quest to cancel that. 12 attack. Balrog is not something I'm really interested in dealing with. Okay. 3 threat in the staging area, so I make 2 progress that I don't need. Now I think I go to the Dark Pit. I haven't calculated the amount of damage I can do, but I'm pretty sure it'll be enough. Could be famous last words. We'll see. So let's see, I've got Feint, so. Yeah, that makes sense. So it doesn't matter where the Sept of Flame is. Let's just put him here so that I can see his shadow card. And shuffle the battle deck. Okay, and. Okay, so I have to do something different. So I can kill my Errand Rider. That's fine. And the other Balrog attack I can feint. Avoid all the shadow cards, so actually I can just defend both the remaining attacks with Baragon. And cancel that. Actually, no, I'm not, because it adds more attack to Faramir. Counter deck, he just slowing down a bit. There should be finished with quests. This should be face up anyway. Okay, that's fine. Dragon has 7 defense. So, if I spend all Faramir's resources, I can fully heal Baragon, that's the thing. Faramir is up to 5 attack. So we can attack for 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 18. So I do 15 damage. So that's 29 damage out of the 27 hit points. So that's cool. Let's heal Baragond and ready and heal again. And then of course we're going into the refresh phase, so I don't need to spend the other resources. So there's nothing else I can do with them either. Well, I suppose that there's a little bit of, still doesn't matter. So control. Oh. Let's ping on the mountain for a moment. No, I shouldn't have done that. Because I want to keep the high value things in my deck. Although, well, it's not really an issue. Durin's Bane has 1 hit point. The chances of me getting all zeros if I use, is exceedingly low. I guess I'll keep the one in my hand since I have actually done that now. I can actually go digging for no, that is not a good one's greeting. Heal barrier. And exhaust 3 characters to discard the top 3 cards of my deck. Okay, so I actually only got a value of 2, but that's fine because Durin's Bane has 1 hit point left. So Durin's Bane is thrown down the dark pit. And I've won the game. And that was much easier than the other time that I tried it. Just got the right draws. Having the Gondorian shield right from the start made a huge difference. The early Glaive line was good. Just all the allies just came out. And the encounter deck didn't get too brutal with me. These guys early on can really screw things up actually, because they force you to engage things when you're not ready for them. Whereas normally you can take a couple of rounds before you deal with any enemies other than Durin's Bane you want. So yeah, that worked out very well. Decks do work, they do function sensibly sometimes, at least. Yeah. So that is it. That brings me to the end of the Nightmare Dwaradelph cycle. Next time we move on to the Nightmare Hobbit boxes. Working my way through quite nicely. If you enjoyed this video, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Thank you for watching and goodbye.